In this video, we're going to create a small game, a ball in a basket game, where we're going to create two objects, majorly one ball, basket. I'm going to create one more object with a pole. So what we do in this, the ball just falls from a random position, and the basket at the bottom on a floor, we're just going to catch it through, right? So let me just get into it. So as you know, we have a three function, the init, where I'm going to specify a viewer. You can see my auto -2 to +2, both left, right, bottom, top, near, far, both x, y, and z direction. And the display, we're going to create an object, and in the main, as we know, we're going to interact with the windows. And all these functions we already explained with in the other videos. Let me just directly dig into it. So nothing we have, we just gone with the initial function. If we just run, I just going to get a blank screen with a white background, right? Why white? Because I'm going to specify with a clear color, RGB, both 1, 1, 1 means a white color. Now I'm going to create an object. So first of all, let me just create a ball. To create a ball, I'm going to use with a three-dimensional object. That is the reason I had use a glut depth here as well as a depth test, since I'm going to create one sphere as a ball. So I write GL a wired or a solid. I'm just going to glut wired sphere. I'm going to take a radius as a 1, 1, slice 25 and 25, so that'll be fine for me. And I'm just going to give some color to it. So GL color 3f, I'm going to give a red color. Perfect. Okay, now as you know, we got a sphere, right? I don't need a ball such a big, so I'm just going to reduce the size of it. So rather than 1 as a radius, I give 0.2. see, this all goes with a -2 to +2. So the left part is a -2, right part is a -2. In that, 0.2 as my radius, so I get this one. This is my ball. Okay, now the ball, what I'm going to do, I'm going to translate it to eyeball screen. So before that, I'm going to create a basket. So rather than create a basket, so I'm just going with a cone. Okay, so rather than keeping it here, okay, we'll do it. So I'm going to create a ball first. So one function, void ball, and I keep the ball in here. So there is a lack of a confusion. I just keep it cutting here. I paste this one through. Yes, and I call the ball here. My ball is also the particular radius has been created. Now I'm going to create my basket. So we create void basket. Yes, so here I'm going to call the basket. I'm going to give a basket with some other color. I say GL color 3f. Okay, so I give it with a red, green. And I create a basket with a glut wire cone. I can use a cone rather than a cube cone. Okay, so I give a base with some radius. I give it with a 0.5, some radius. Just the width is little more than the sphere, and I give a height as a 0.5. okay, slice 25 and 25. Let me just check into it. Okay, so now you have a cone, but you want it to be aligned to a y-axis, so you need to rotate it. Before that, let me just reduce the size of it, the radius of it. I just give it as a 0.3 here. Okay, perfect. Okay, now this radius is fine for me. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to rotate this one out. So what I just do, I write GL rotate f above the basket. I want to rotate only to a basket. I'm going to rotate into a 90 degree in the x-axis, right? We already know what the rotation in the x-axis looks like. Yeah, now perfect. Now the cone was like that. Now it has been rotated in the x-axis. Now it has come here. Now what is my next goal? Next goal is to keep the cone on the floor, that is my basket, and keep the ball on the top of the screen, right? I keep it here. So I have to translate the ball first. But what happens if I do GL translate F here? I'll just do that. I'm going to translate. I'm not going to translate in the x-axis, but I'm going to translate in the y-axis. To what extent? To extend as a 1, or rather than a 1, I give it as a 2, and z-axis as a 0. So why are given as a 2? Why? Because bottom is minus 2, plus is top is plus 2. So from 0, you have to go to a plus 2. Now as you can see, both the ball as well as the cone has been gone to this position. That means this translate F has been applied to a ball as well as a basket. Right? Why? Because whenever you use the transformation function, whichever the object below it, for all the object will be affected. Now you can see the rotate F is not affected to a ball, it's affected only to a basket. Why? Because the ball is above the basket. Right, so what I'm going to do, so to control the translate F only to a ball, I'm just going to put the push and the pop matrix. I write GL push matrix 1 and GL pop matrix 2. Now the translate F is affected only to a particular ball. Now you can see it has been gone here. So rather than translating to a 2, I just give it as a 1.8. So it'll be inside the screen, the entire ball, right? So that is inside a screen. Now I'm just going to translate the cone below on the floor, so that will be a minus 1.8. so again, I just put the GL push matrix as well as a GL pop matrix below the object, GL pop matrix. Okay, and I'm going to add the translate F. I'm going to add it above the rotate F because I need the rotation first, then the translation. GL translate F. So I'm not going to translate in the X, but in the Y, I'm going to translate to minus 1.8. Okay, we'll see this, and a 0. We'll run this one again. Okay, now the basket has gone down. Why? Because the height of the basket is 0.5. So since the height of the basket is 0.5, so you have to give minus 1.5, right? So to come on the floor. Yeah, perfect. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to create one pole. Let me just create one pole though. So from a pole or a pipe where the ball going to be fallen down. So I just create one pole or a pipe, void pipe or a pole. Okay, fine. Pole is my object. So I'm going to create a pole where I create with a color, GL color 3F with a blue color, right? And GL glut solid cube, I just create with a radius, okay, with a radius 0.5. Let me just see this one out. That will become in the middle. Okay, what happened? Solid cube with a blue color, glut solid cube with a blue color. I didn't call this, yes. So the pole should need to be called. Yes, should need to be called here. Yeah, we do this. Okay, now it has been come here. So what I just do, so I increase the radius to 1. Perfect, right? So I'm just going to sync it in the y-axis, so I need to apply the scale F. So before applying anything, so I just going to add a push and a pop so that the other function should not be affected. GL pop, and I'm going to apply the scale to it, GL scale F. Right, so I'm not going to scale it in the x-axis anything, right, but I'm going to scale it in the y-axis. I reduce the size to a half, so 0.5. I'm not going to scale it in the z-axis. Right, now it has been scaled over here. Now let me just increase a bit size in the x-axis, and 0.4 I keep. So my pipe, the pole just looks like this. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to place this pole next to a ball, so that looks like the ball coming out from a pipe. So what I just do, I just need to translate it here. I just copy the translate of the ball, wherever the ball has been there. So this translate up, and I'm going to paste this one out. Now the pipe has been placed on a ball, so I have to translate it little bit on the positive x-axis. So what I just do, I just give it as a 0.5, so then that will be fine, I feel. Now still, so I have to go with a 0.8. Yeah, so I give it a 1.0. Let me just check. Perfect. So rather than 1.0, I give it a 0.9. Yeah, that will be fine. Yes, now what I just need to do, I need to make the ball to fall down every time. So to do this, I just take one value. Yeah, so before that, let me just give a position to it. So I have a position for a ball, basket, as well as for the pole. So I take some variable, I take it as a float. I take as a ball x, a ball x axis, the ball's x axis is a 0, and the ball y, I keep the y capital, x and y capital, so it'll be easier for me to refer. So that will be a 1.8, and then I come to a basket x will be a, as you can see, it's a 0, basket x. And basket y is minus 1.5, and then I go with a pole x, which is equal to, what do you have, 0.9, and pole y, which is equal to 1.8. yes. So now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to change this value as a ball x, and this one as a ball y, x-axis and the y-axis. That means here in the translate, I go with a basket x, as well as this one as a basket y. Yeah, perfect. Now we have a pole x and the pole y. Now once this has been done, now we get the same output here. So I just write it into a variable. Now I just make the ball to fall. If I need to make the ball to fall, I need to decrement the ball's y-axis, right? So this is the x-axis and the y-axis. We have to decrement the ball y-axis so that the ball can be fallen down. So every time the display execute, so before, what I need to do, if you are doing animation, you have to write a GL load identity, that is a must and should. And inside it, I'm just going to make the ball's x-axis, ball y-axis, I'm just going to decrement -0.002. okay, I'll just make this one 0.02, will be a huge 0.02. I just make this here, and I have to make glut pose redisplay for the animation. This glut pose redisplay will execute the display again and again. Every time the display execute, the ball's y-axis will be decremented, and that will be put in before the ball, so the ball is coming down, the translating down. You can see the ball is falling down. Now we have to control, if the ball reaches to the floor, I have to make it to come back again. So so I have to write the condition here. So as you know, my ortho, the bottom is a -2, right, left, right, bottom, top, bottom is a -2. So what I have to make here, so if the ball reaches -2, if the ball y reaches minus 2 is or I say greater than minus 2, right? So if it is reaches less than minus 2, so then I make the ball y to initial position. So what is my initial position? The ball y is a plus 1.8. 1.8 is my initial position, right? If I made this one out, ball y is less than, not greater than. If it is less than minus 2, then I have to bring it back to our initial position, right? So now it goes back and now it slopes again. Yes, perfect. Now I have to make the this thing, the pole, the basket to be moved. So what I make, I link the keyboard, the left arrow as well as the right arrow to a basket. To do this, I have to take the keyboard function. Rather than the keyboard function, I use a special function. Why the special function? Why? Because I have to link it to a left and right arrow. You want to link it to arrows of the keyboard, then you have to use a glut special function. I use a special function. I name it as a yes keys, special keys. Yes is my function. So then I'm going to create that function, void yes keys is my function, then int key, then int x, int y. Perfect. Now I'm going to write if my key double equal to glut key left, key underscore left, that means a left key. So then what I have to do, I have to take the basket x axis and I'm going to decrement it with some value. I just take it as 0.3, right? So I copy this one out. Yeah, I paste it, left key right. I take the right key. Then I'm going to add it with the plus 0.3. Now I run this. I'm pressing the left arrow and the right arrow. Now I'm making the basket to move using my keyboard key. Right, left and right keys. Now what next I have to do? I have to make every time when the ball reaches to a ground, I make the ball to come in the random position. Now I have to take it as a random position. Now there are different ways to give a random position. One, you can take a random. So that is what I prefer. So I take one value, int. Okay, so I just take it as a int, a random. Okay, and I take one r to store the random. Okay, r and the random. So now every time the display executes, now every time the ball reaches to a 2, so I just put this one as a block, ball size has to be increased, that I agree with that. I control x, right? I keep it here. So I create the random position. So I just create the random position. R is equal to rand. I just keep it as a percentage 4. Percentage 4 means the any random number between 0 to 3 will be created. Yes. So the random should be, how to add the stdlib here. Hash include random as defined inside stdlib. stdlib.h. Yes, so now we have a random percentage 4. Well, I think we have to define it something like this. Yeah, random, I have to define the random, then random percentage 4. So any random number will be created. So I write if r double equal to 0, I give one position to it. So I change the ball x axis. Change it to some value, so minus 1.8, right? So I copy it again. If r value is equal to 1, I give it as a ball axis a minus 1, and if r value is equal to 2, random number is equal to 2, I make the ball to be created to a plus 1 ball x, and then If the R value is equal to 3, I make the ball to be created to plus 1.8. The 4 places on a screen in the x-axis, I'm just going to create with. Now it will reaches to a ground. Now it has come to a random position. Now it just falls from the all the random positions. Yeah, perfect. So now along with the pole also should need to be moved. So the pole x-axis also should be changed. So I have to give the same thing to a pole. Pole x-axis should be minus 1.8. Perfect. So I just copy this one out. And this one will be minus 1. And then again, this one will be plus 1. And this one will be plus 1.8. Perfect. So I run this one out here. So first, this is a position. Now, okay. Yeah. So why this comes here? Why? Because the pole axis, whatever we have, pole initial position is 0.9. So we have to add the 0.9 when we are subtracting with the initial position. So I just give it with the 0.9 everywhere. Right? So otherwise, the pole starts from the random position here. The ball will fall from the middle of the pole. That should not be happen here. Yes. Now it falls. Perfect. Now it goes here. This position. Now this. Right, you can make the pole to come in the any position. Yeah, perfect. So the pole will just start from the random. So you just need to mask the basket. Okay, now this has been done. Now the next part what we have is a catching a ball. Now how do I can catch the ball? Now what I just make, if the ball touches the basket, now I make the ball to fall first, right? I make that things to be happen. And then the speed control and all will be done extra. Okay, now what should be done? The how to catch the ball. So to do this, I have to print the position of the ball x-axis and the basket x-axis. Basket xy, ball xy. So I'm just going to print this one out. So I put the printf. Before putting a printf, I have to add scdio.h hash include scdio.h and this one out. I'm just going to print the position, printf. So I just print percentage F, so slash n, otherwise I just name it ball x axis, that will be a percentage F slash n, and I just call it as a ball x. Perfect. Okay, so I copy this one out, I paste it again, I name it as a ball y. And this is a ball y. Yeah, similarly I name it as a basket x. So and this part will be a basket y, basket x similarly. So I just give this one as a basket y and this one will be a basket y. Perfect. Right, so once this has been done, so I'm just going to see what my x-axis and still as a y-axis here. Okay, now you can see the basket x-axis and the y-axis. When the basketball reaches to this point near the basket, the ball y-axis will be a minus 1.8. You can check this one, right? When it reaches to this point, the basket y-axis is a minus 1.8, right? 1.8 or a 1.6, I can stop at this. So that first I'll just do, I'm just going to stop the ball if it is reaches to a 1.8. So for to do that, I just take one flag, I out flag, the flag out, when we should be out, I indicate as a 0 the ball y axis is less than minus 1.8, I'm going to set the flag out. I'm going to set it as a 1. Now This ball y is equal to 0.02. That means the ball is falling down. I'm going to control the ball falling down. If the flag out is equal to 0, then only I make the ball to fall down. Otherwise, I never make the ball to be fallen down. So that means if the ball reaches to a particular down, 1.8, I'll stop. Yeah, this is the point I have to stop. But remember, so rather than 1.8, it's better I keep it as a 1.5. I'll stop it. I make the game is out. So till the 1.5, I think the basket height, perfect, right? I'll stop the ball to a 1.5. Okay, now, but the disadvantage here, so this cannot be controlled. Why? Because even the basket is not there. If it is reaches to a particular height, then it will stop. Now I have to check the basket's x-axis as well as the y-axis. Now I make the x-axis of a basket. The basket x-axis is a 0, okay, and the basket y-axis is a 1.5. We have nothing to do with the basket's y-axis. We just need to go to a basket's x-axis. Now, if the basket's x-axis, the radius here is a 0.3. So the basket x-axis minus 0.3. So I take a graph sheet. Just erase everything. So I take here basket x-axis minus 0.3 x-axis, and this one will be basket x-axis plus 0.3. okay, and this is a part we have a ball x-axis. Now if the ball x-axis is between this and the height is less than 1.5, minus 1.5, then we have to make it as out. So perfect. So I go here, go to my project. Now the ball y-axis should be 1.5, and I write and here, and the condition I write the basket, sorry, ball x-axis, ball x should be, where is my graph sheet, should be, if the ball x-axis is greater than basket x-axis minus 0.3, ball x-axis is greater than basket x-axis greater than minus 0.3, and I write another and, ball x-axis is less than basket x plus 0.3, and we make basket x plus less than this and greater than this, right? If this point, then the ball is in the exact position, then we make the fallout to be happen. You can see now I just remove the basket away. Now it retypes, but when I reaches to that particular height, now the ball has been stopped. And see this, right? Ball has been stopped. Now that means, so that is out. And now we have to do it in the reverse way. We should not be the when the ball reaches to a floor, then we have to announce it as out. Otherwise, we have to continue it. So how do I can do? So if the ball reaches the floor, that means a minus 2. Whatever the code I have it here, I copy this one out. I cut it. And I put it inside the condition. Okay. I put it inside the condition. And this flag out, I cut it from here. I put it whenever it reaches to a minus 2. Right. So I run it back again. Now, so if the ball hits to a particular basket, then it continues. Right, if it is hit touch to a ground, then it stops, it's out. Right, so my game is done. So you can design this pole however you want. So even the background, you can design it. Now next part, what I'm going to do, I'm going to increment the ball speed when I catch by the basket, when the basket catches it 3 times. So what I can do, so this part, ball y, sorry, so where we have ball y is getting decremented, and this will be controlled by the ball speed. So I just take one more float variable. I take it as a ball speed. I give it as a 0, and I take one count. I'll take it as a count, as an integer, as a 0. Now here what I just do, ball y-axis is getting decremented, that means the ball is falling down, plus ball speed. Now the initially the ball speed is 0. As you can see, the ball speed is 0. So 0 plus minus 1.8 will be a 0.002 plus ball speed 0 will be a 0.002. Now every time the ball touches the basket, I increment the count. Count value will be plus plus every time I increment the count. Now, so what I do, if count reaches to 3, or I just make count percentage 3 double equal to 0, that means every time the count has been multiplied with a 3, 3, 6, 9, count value reaches to that, then the ball speed I'm going to increment. I'm going to increment with a small value, 0.01. Okay, 0.01, perfect. There are some mistakes here. What have we done? Okay, so what happens in the initial only, so the count value is never incremented. So I just go with this, the count value double equal to 3 if it is reaches to 3, and then reaches to 3, then I make the count value is equal to 0, right? I initialize the count again, so every time when it touches the basket again, it will be incremented. Otherwise, the 0% 3 will be a 0. Okay, so 1, count value is 1 now, count value is 2, and now the count value is 3. Now the ball speed is got incremented. As you can see, ball speed is getting incremented. 3, again, the ball speed is incremented. Yeah, now it's out. Right. Every 3 iteration, the ball speed is incremented. You don't want to increment in this scenario, 0.001. You just can reduce it 0.0008, right? Still it will be getting incremented. And this is a small game what we have been created with a ball and basket. And the main condition here, how to make the ball out, right? When to make the game over, this is the initial condition we have to calculate through, right? Like this, we can develop any kind of a game using your screen, and we can build our project. Yes, thank you.